This edition of Championship Reflections on the 2002 Northeastern Volleyball Team is brought to you by Aero Seat Incorporated in Sterling.
If you've ever dreamed of flying, you can make that dream become a reality and get your FFA private pilot certification. Aero Seat Incorporated in Sterling is offering a ground and flight school starting on November 6th. For more information, call 970-522-1941.
It's been 15 years since Northeastern Volleyball won the Region 9 title, and the Northeastern Volleyball team in 2002 was coached by Marci Henry, who's now the athletic director at Northeastern Junior College. It's hard to believe that 15 years has gone by since the school last won a Region 9 volleyball title, but since this team last won.
It is a long time, and yeah, it is hard to... 15 years is a long time ago. It's hard to remember, you know, so many... ins and outs of the season, but what I do remember is a bunch of really great kids who worked really hard to win a championship.
One of the things that was unique to that time of volleyball that we now don't see is that was back when college volleyball went to 30. That's something that you and I both remembered kind of reminiscing through some of these books. Different approach to the game from a coaching standpoint, for sure.
You know, when we went away from, I guess we call it regular scoring to rally scoring, we really weren't sure. It was kind of an experiment. And yes, we played to 30 that year. And as we were talking, I do think it was the next year that it was changed to 25. But yeah, the game was a little bit longer than it is now.
A little bit longer, and the region looked a little bit different. For fans that have become accustomed to the Region 9 North and South, it was built completely different at that time as well.
It was. At that time within the region, we didn't have any Division II schools playing volleyball, which we do now, and hence that was our North-South division. Back then, since all of the schools in Nebraska were participating in Division I, we had an East and a West region, so we were in the West.
So your rivals were not necessarily Western Nebraska, even though you did play, you know, every season. Your rivals were more the Wyoming schools.
Absolutely, and I think Eastern Wyoming, Casper, those were probably two of our biggest rivals, I think, at the time.
You also, the international player wasn't as predominant within junior college volleyball at that time, so the team build is very different than maybe you see now in junior college volleyball.
Well, that's what's interesting is this team that won the region didn't have one international player on it. However, when we got to the national tournament, there were several teams with international players, and I can't recall if the teams that we played within the region had international players at that time or not, but I was very proud of these girls and what they accomplished.
You were able to put this team together with, as you said, not a lot of international kids, but there were actually a lot of local kids, a couple kids from Fort Morgan, several kids from Denver, so that had to really kind of be cool to see these players that were staying home essentially to play.
Absolutely. I think as I look at the picture, I think we only had two girls who were out of state, and the distance they came from was Utah. So very much a Western U.S. team.
You had been the head coach here at NJC since 1999, correct?
Yes.
So when you were kind of building this was kind of just 2-3 years into you being the head coach. Did you feel at the beginning of the year you had something special with this team?
I don't remember. I mean, it's very well possible. I remember chasing after several of these girls in the recruiting process from, you know, running after them at their high school games and then continuing to run after them at their, you know, their club tournaments. And it was a really fun experience getting to know them and know that they were good people with great plans for their futures, and so I'm very, very fortunate that I had that opportunity with them.
Great people is one of the big things that obviously all of Northeastern Athletics really attempts to try and bring in to this day. You had, I think, four all-region players and an academic All-American on this bunch, so that really kind of shows the goodness of several of these players.
Absolutely, and even though we only had one academic All-American, I can tell you that there were several other that were top-notch students as well. So they were top performers in the classroom and on the court.
being able to coach a team takes more than one. I talk about this with every coach. Having a good assistant is very important. And you had an assistant that you were quite fond of, and he got to spend quite a few years as your assistant coach here.
Yes, Robbie was a very good assistant for me. We had very different viewpoints on a lot of things, and that was really good because it balanced, I think, our team. And in many cases, it helped me view things maybe a little differently than I normally would. And I do appreciate that. And he was a much better recruiter in terms of just talking with people and kids than I was. He was the fun one. I was the technical, you know, right, serious one.
You also, you know, Jessica Squire now has the player, you know, the coach she played for is now her athletic director. You had an opportunity to come in here and have Sheila Worley as your AD when you were the head coach here. That had to be nice for you to lean on throughout the time, because I know Sheila's been a huge part of Northeastern athletics.
Absolutely. I was in Sheila's office a lot asking, you know, questions. And one of the things I appreciated about her, too, she officiated volleyball, and so she had two set of eyes out there looking for players for us all the time. And if she saw someone that she thought might make a difference for our team, she certainly let me know, and I followed up on it. So I really appreciated everything that Sheila did from that just to her leadership. She had some very, very good experiences coaching, as well as being on the national level, because she also was involved in the NJCAA. And so I really appreciated her viewpoint.
A lot has changed within the sport, you know, the type of athlete that comes in, the way the game is played now since you guys last won the regional tournament in 2002. Is there one lesson that kind of sticks out that you're able to pass along to your daughter now that she's playing from this team, or from the experience that, you know, the 2002 NJC volleyball team taught you about the sport of volleyball?
I think all of my teams have taught me different lessons throughout the years, and I do try and instill those on her and her team. And but I think one of the biggest, probably the biggest lessons and examples, maybe is a better word, from each of these teams is their perseverance and never giving up and working hard and believing in what they could do. And I see that in Sydney's team, and it's fun to watch.
Marci Henry, who is now the athletic director at Northeastern Junior College, the head coach for the Region 9 volleyball champs, the last Region 9 volleyball champions that Northeastern Junior College has had. And, of course, Northeastern volleyball has been battling WNCC since 2004, has yet to be able to get over that hump. But always exciting, as we're joined by Ken McDowell from the South Platte Sentinel, to win a Region 9 championship in the vein that Northeastern did in 2002.
This was the Region 9 West tournament that NJC was in, and got into the Region 9 West championship game against Casper, and won in four games, 30-20, 30-27, 31-33, and 30-21. And in that championship match, and here's some names that NJC fans could remember. April Prater had 30 kills in the championship match. 30 kills. Sarah Glidden, 23, and freshman Michelle Franzen, 11. Freshman Christy Mortensen had 63 assists. And on defense, freshman Amber Peel, there's a familiar name from around mm-hmm. this area, had 11 or 21 digs. And it was an inspiring win for the Plains women in a way, because in March of 2002, the Plains women basketball team won the Region 9 title in the Bank of Colorado Event Center. And the sophomores on the team, Prater and Scooter Uris and Angie Kaufman and Sean Del Weimer and Tara Thompson, were so inspired by seeing the Plains women basketball team win the Region 9 tournament that they wanted to go do it in volleyball, and they did. And so really that year, for 2002, NJC had a pair of Region 9 champions in women's sports.
They did, and I think one that's very special and something you haven't seen other schools succeed in doing, and that includes NJC, is being able to do it with a lot of local
and Colorado-based talent. That shows you how great the volleyball was in Northeast Colorado and on the Front Range in Denver for Marci Henry to be able to put together a largely Colorado team to win this title.
It really was. And that was Marci, only Marci's fourth year, going into fourth year, because I think she took over the volleyball program in 1998 or 1999 when she came in. And, of course, that win put NJC volleyball in the national tournament for the fifth time in the history of the school. And they went to West Plains, Missouri. And the previous trip to the Nationals was in 1993. And Sue Pollard was the coach of the team then. But in 2002, NJC was 1-2 to close out the season with a 45-15 mark. 1-2 in the national tournament. They lost in the opening round to College of Southern Idaho, and in the consolation bracket defeated Wallace State, Alabama in straight sets. And then in the next match, they played a team that I'm very familiar with, being from Illinois, Lakeland College, Illinois, from Mattoon, Illinois, and got swept in that match. But it was very, very nice to see NJC get to the Nationals. Now, you know, it had been 9 years, but, you know, to get there. And it's been a while since, because it's been all Western Nebraska. I think in 2004 is when NJC and Western Nebraska started this unbelievable string of being in the championship match every year in the Region 9 South tournament. So and we say it every year, but it's going to happen. It's going to happen. It could happen this year.
It could happen. And I think that the 15-year mark of this team last winning a Region 9 title is a amount of history that Jessica Squire, a former Northeastern player, can remember, and that a lot of people are looking at as a real possibility for this team to be there. And it's really exciting, because now Marci Henry has transitioned into the athletic director at Northeastern Junior right. College and opened up the door to continue a great tradition of volleyball within Region 9 that this team, the last team to win the Region 9 championship, now represents.
And, you know, when that happens, when NJC ends that string, it's going to be pretty special, because there's actually been two head coaches in NJC who have played on those teams during that stretch in those championship losses to Western Nebraska. Of course, one is Jessica Squire and the other one is Amber Wiedemann. And Amber played and then coached when Marci took over the job as athletic director. So it's got in sometime, but boy, this Plains Women program has been exciting to watch ever since I've been here. And I do remember that was such an exciting year, and to get that Region 9 West title was pretty special.
In 2002, the Region 9 West title for Northeastern was won over Casper Community College. It was the fourth year of the existence of two subdivisions in the Region 9 up until 1999. Region 9 volleyball competed in one, but as the region continued to expand and add teams, it allowed opportunities for the division to be split. And then in 2004, when North Platte Community College and Central Community College dropped down to Division II, NJCAA Athletics had allowed for the restructuring of the North and South of the Region 9. And since then, Northeastern Junior College has been in the South with WNCC. And since then, WNCC has defeated Northeastern Junior College every single season for the Region 9 championship. Well, up on the North side, you have seen Western Wyoming and Casper and Northwest College all be able to get in the mix and win regional titles and go to the national tournament. Region 9 does get two players, and there's always conversations about getting additional teams into the regional tournament and what way would do that. This year, of course, is case in point, with the North side only having one team with a winning record, and that is Laramie County Community College. Everybody else is still currently sub 500, while in the South, only one team went into sub-region play with a losing record overall. It seems like the South is an awful lot stronger this season, but that's what makes it fun to cover volleyball at Northeastern Junior College. And in my 10th year as the radio voice at Northeastern Junior College, I feel that someday, and someday relatively soon, we'll see Northeastern Junior College get over the WNCC hump and move themselves to the national tournament for the first time since 2002. That's Championship Reflections on the 2002 Region 9 Northeastern Volleyball Champions.
This edition of Championship Reflections on the 2002 Northeastern Volleyball Team has been brought to you by Aero Seat Incorporated in Sterling.
If you've ever dreamed of flying, you can make that dream become a reality and get your FFA private pilot certification. Aero Seat Incorporated in Sterling is offering a ground and flight school starting on November 6th. For more information, call 970-522-1941.